This is a video showing how to export the journal from SparkVue. I've previously collected some data. Prior to collecting my snapshot, I wanted to display the data in a manner that's going to give it the most information. To do that, I will click on the graph tools, and then I'll select the auto scale. This changes the display so that the data is spread over the entire graph area. If additional analyses are required, go ahead and do those prior to capturing the screenshot, or the snapshot rather. So we can select the selection tool, click, hold, and drag over the area that you want to analyze. Click on Done. Then you can go down and select the curve fits, and we can select a linear curve fit, and select OK. Now position the curve fit equations away from the line so that you can capture all of this data within the screenshot. Once you've composed the graph in a way that you want to display the data, then go ahead to the upper right-hand side and click on the camera icon to take the snapshot. Once that snapshot is taken, the pages of the journal are shown to the right-hand side. So if you want to capture another image of the graph, you can rearrange the analysis on that graph and then again click on the snapshot icon. So you can see that the second journal page is displayed down below. To export the journal, go ahead and select the Share button at the top, and then go down and select the Export Journal at the bottom. The exported journal will be exported into a zipped file that contains both the images and the HTML file information to display it within a web page. So we'll click on Export Journal. I'm now going to select my drive, or my Google Drive here, to export this. So we'll call this temperature data. Please make sure that you only single click on it, as the new folder icon will appear behind it, and oftentimes you can create a new folder without intending to. So we'll call this temperature data. And again, this is in a zip folder file format. So we'll click on save. The next video will show how to download the zip folder to the Chromebook so that the files can be manipulated within the Google Docs environment.